Hi, welcome back to our spread spectrum test setup. I have once again configured my arbitrary waveform generator to output a fixed frequency, this time at 2.5 MHz. And I have set the spectrum analyzer to the same center frequency with a span of 4 MHz and a resolution bandwidth of 20 kHz. Now, until now, we were always using a rectangular signal to modulate our waveform. This is not the only way spread spectrum can be achieved. We could use a sine wave, a triangular wave, up ramp, down ramp, or even a patented waveform called the Hershey-Kiss waveform to modulate our signal. Let me just turn on frequency modulation and show you the different waveforms. Now I'm modulating with a square wave with an FM frequency of 20 kHz and a deviation of 500 kHz. And as we can see, the spectrum is spread, we don't have one peak anymore, but at the ends of the spectrum we can see those huge peaks extending out. This is not really what we want for spread spectrum or for EMI reduction. We want to have the flattest possible top. So let's see if we can achieve this by using a different waveform. Let's just jump straight over to the sine wave, and we can already see the spectrum has improved quite a lot. We still have those peaks sticking out a little bit, but overall the top is way flatter than with the square wave. Now let's try a triangular wave, and we can see the spectrum is even better than with the sine wave. Now there are still those tiny peaks extending, but overall it's really extremely flat. Now when we have a look at the up ramp, we can see this is really one of the best modulation signals because we've got a very flat top and we're spreading the energy over a very wide spectrum. And the down ramp really doesn't make any significant difference anymore. So yeah, that's it for the modulation waveforms. And in the next video, we will show how the frequency deviation affects the spectrum. And then we will give you a practical example on how to use spread spectrum modulation.